Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78. Hope you guys are doing well today, by the way. And we are here in Los Angeles, California, continuing our milk run down to Sierra Vista, Arizona. Take a look at the manifest here real quick. 59,000 pounds of milk going down to Walbert there in Sierra Vista. Of course, as you can see, we are in the JK Trucking T680. Hope everyone's doing well today, by the way. Let's go out here, get started. Had a pretty good run so far. We're all rested up, all fueled up, all ready to go. Let's go out here and get after it today. Let's take a look at the map just real quick. I don't know. Yeah, there's no way we're getting down to Sierra Vista today. So we started out all the way up here. And it took us about a good 30 minutes to get from San Rafael to LA. So we might get as far as Phoenix today. Then hopefully nothing goes wrong between here and there. And we're able to finish the run. So I know there are a couple, about a week or so ago, we were doing that run down to, up to Redding, California. But messing around with the game and everything, taking some mods in and out, and it messed up that file, so it put us back in a garage in San Francisco, and that's why we started out this run in San Rafael. Busy morning here in LA. Thought I could have made it, but not so much. How cool this guy's gonna let us go. Thank you, sir. That's a good way to start out the day. Someone being rather courteous, letting us out, letting us get our day started. One thing I talked about there, and yeah, we got it. We got it. In the last video that I wanted to mention right off the bat here, started to mess around with the video quality just a little bit, specifically the upload to YouTube there. So yeah, I capture everything. I play in 2560 by 1440p. But for whatever reasons, the videos hadn't been showing up in 1440p. They've only been, at least for me, they've only been showing up in 1080, so I'd imagine that'd be the same way for everyone else. So I started to upload them in, render them in 4K, and upload there in 4K. So let me know if you've noticed any difference over the last few videos in quality or anything like that. It looks a little bit clearer, looks a little bit crisper. And if you're able to see it in any resolution other than 1080p. And of course, as always, links for anything I'm using are down in the video description, so be sure to check that out. You'll find a lot of the stuff out there on the Steam Workshop, so. At least as of this recording, no updates on the T680. Still plugging away at that. Probably get hopefully get a lot done to it after or in between the time you guys see this video and the time that I'm recording it. Been working a little bit harder on kind of getting some stuff kind of in the queue there, like I was a couple weeks ago, which worked out pretty well. But last week, like I said, there in the one video there last week, kind of a goofy week last week, so That's why the uploads were a little bit more sparse than usual. We're going to get back after it this week and get this thing back on track. Not that it really derailed or anything, just, you know. I don't know what I'm saying. And that's kind of the weird thing about sitting down and recording, you know, some stuff in bulk, if you will. You know, after I record this, you know, I'm going to get some other stuff done. Get LSPDFR, start cracking away on that. Try to get that back up and running. Just haven't had much time to do much of anything, you know, with that work-life balance and then, you know, trying to find time to do this, all that stuff. This is not something I do full time. This is just a hobby. So whenever I can squeeze in a little bit of time to sit down and record some content, I absolutely take that opportunity to do that. Okay, traffic's being just a little bit sketchy this morning, so we are gonna try to stay right here at about 55. I don't like when they get all bunched up like this. That's about the time someone decides to do, hey, I haven't done a brake check yet today. But still just cracking away at some mods there, trying to get some stuff updated. All that good stuff. See what I mean? That bus is up there going, eh, well, yeah, we should probably do a brake check right about now. Okay. Still kind of waiting to hear some updates from SES on what they plan on doing next, if there's going to be any trucks coming out soon. And we're just about, about 3 weeks away? Right around there, 2, 3, 4 weeks away from the 1 year anniversary of ATS, so that's pretty cool. So I just kind of wonder if they'll drop anything on us for the 1 year anniversary. Maybe some unexpected DLC or, you know, new truck, new skins, you know, something. I was checking out the MHA site there the other day, and they're working on some updates to their mod. Sounds like they kind of basically got to start over from scratch, but they are going to be supporting the rescale, which is pretty cool. Once they get that up and going, I will absolutely be checking that out, but sounds like it could be a little while yet. That's really the only map mod I've really used here in ATS. It's just a nice little addition to the stock map, so. Got our crew set there. Different little rest area. Not sure if I've seen that before. I'm sure I probably have, I just never really noticed it probably, but you kind of figure that traffic would have thinned out up there by now. And maybe some cars will hop off here on this exit. Nope. Stay bunched up for a while, it looks like. It's okay, we'll just stay back here and keep our eye on them, I guess. Sorry, dude. Say this has been a nice laid-back run so far. Nothing crazy's happened. Just been out here on the interstate just getting after it. Kind of nice. I think that's one of the things I like most about this game, and especially since the rescale is, it can be so relaxing sometimes just to sit down and just drive in this game on these long stretches. One thing's for sure, with that DP's traffic mod, lane changing is a little bit more, I'm not going to say it's more difficult, but it's a lot more realistic, that's for sure. You just can't freely switch lanes kind of here and there. If you get, kind of stuck out here in the left-hand lane or whatever, you're trying to get over into the left-hand lane or just change lanes in general, it takes just a couple seconds. You know, hopefully someone's nice enough to, let you over or whatever. And it's traffic today's like, nope. You are staying over there, sir. I guess we'll just stay over here then. Tried getting over. Oh, now we need to get over. Oh, sweet. That's a beautiful thing right there. The bypass on the way station. Domino's got pulled in though. Traffic is just nuts today. I'll try this again. got an exit coming up here pretty soon, so. Unless the GPS is going to do one of those goofy things and tells us to get off the interstate just to get back on the interstate. Kind of what that looked like there at first. Or actually, I think that's just like a rest area, probably, now that I look at that. So guys, what have you been up to lately? I don't think that's anything. Yeah, it's just, yeah. That's a goofy little thing where it has you go through that rest area because reasons, I guess. I hope they can get that sorted out in an update here pretty soon. No, not that it's a huge deal or game breaking or anything like that. It's just kind of annoying. Evasive maneuvers. Achievement completed. And we're stuck back out here in the left-hand lane again. Good times. All right, not so bad this time, I guess. At least traffic seems like it's starting to thin out a little bit. I know there for a while it was getting pretty congested. Looks like it's kind of building up behind us again, so. Just about to Phoenix, man. We're making some pretty decent time. So I thought it would took us a little bit longer to get to Phoenix, but cruising right along. Might be able to knock this out in today's run. We'll have to see. Worst case scenario is we start off the next episode, finish the delivery, and grab another load. That's kind of what we do. What we do. gotta hit my exit. Didn't miss it. Nothing's coming. Double bonus. Could be here for a minute or two. Might be clear that way. Can't really see through that fence. What, dude? Kind of need that space. That'd probably be better if I didn't take off in five low. Pro tip of the day brought to you by Moose 78. Waiting for that. Just glanced down there, seeing we were doing almost 35. He's like, I better slow down, and then he got us. And he got us. This is kind of brutal. That ramp was going to get us there. Thought the thing was going to die going up that. Almost 60,000 pounds of milk on here. Shnikes. know, that milk tanker looks pretty cool back there. Too far out. We are not too far out. Might just go ahead and finish this one up today. Can't be much more than 10 minutes out or so. Shoot. See if for the next load, see if we can't get the Manac flatbed there that has the side kit on it. I think that'd look really good with this too. Maybe change out the wheels instead of going with the white steelies, go with some polished aluminum. Spice it up a little bit. Blue there. So probably what we'll do is we'll just hit the rest area, get some rest, and deliver this tomorrow morning. Grab some freight here out of Sierra Vista and repeat that process. Do it all over again. So, don't need to be that guy and driving around with my turn signal on for like 3 miles. Stop about a mile back. There we go. Okay, nice little truck stop over there. We will hit that. Is that where it has us going, or? Yeah, well, I guess we'll just go this way. Now, if I can get traffic to stop. Oh, look at that. Yeah, nice big parking lot over here. Very cool. I know I've not been, I want to put that in reverse. I know I've not been down to this part of the map yet since the rescale, so this is pretty cool. Side a little bit more room to back into the spot. What in the hell, people? Whoops. Look around, see what's going on, and kind of rubbed up against the pole there. Whoopsie. It's getting kind of late in the evening there anyway, so we'll just say chances are the farm was closed, or Walbert was, you know, not taking receiving anything, so got an appointment for first thing in the morning, so we'll get some rest, make our delivery first thing in the morning, grab a load out of Sierra Vista, and like I said, they would do it all over again. Alright guys, that's going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories from the Road. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video. If so, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. Until the next video, stay safe out there, guys. Take care, and we'll be seeing ya.